All right, in this one we're gonna learn about the getline function, which is very useful when, well, you can probably guess what it does. It reads a file line by line. And yeah, this is very common, especially if you rewrite utilities like the regular Unix utilities, like for example the world count, or there is also tier, stuff like that, or cut, or these kinds of just shell utilities. And so here's the function definition. So you just give it a pointer to a line pointer, the size of the memory at that pointer, and a file. And what is interesting about this function is that you start by giving it something you allocated for the line where to store the characters it read, or null. And if it will start reading the line, and if the size of the line is too long, it will reallocate your pointer to fit the size. And so if you get longer and longer lines, it's okay. It will automatically reallocate the memory for you. And this also means that you don't need to reallocate the buffer at every single line. It's just you can reuse the same buffer for the line, and so it's very efficient. Let's use it here. You can see that I open a file foo, and then I close the file. The foo file looks a bit like this, just a bunch of lines, and then I have longer lines. And so let's declare a char pointer to line. Let's make it null. Then let's have a variable to store the length of the line, which will be equal to zero at the start. And next, we want to just make a while loop where we call getline. And then you give it a pointer to your line pointer, so that, of course, it needs a pointer to the pointer to, because it needs to, if it reallocates it, it needs to change the value of the pointer itself, not the characters in the line. Then you give it a pointer to the line length. Again, the line length will be the full size of the buffer, not really the size of the line itself. So I should maybe rename it line buffer size, buffer line, which will make it clearer. Then we have a file, and it will return -1 if there is an error, but also if it's the end of the file, it will also return -1. And to check, of course, that there wasn't an error, you know, for example, assert that it was indeed the end of the file. And if it's not the end of the file, well, you got some other sort of error, like it couldn't read the file or stuff like this. And of course, since it allocated the line for you with malloc or realloc, you need to free the line after. So and here you get just you just get a pointer to the line, so you can just printf just say line is equal to this, and let's just print the line for now, and see what it does. Just main a.out, and as you can see, it returns the line, but including the null. Including the new line character. So, here you can see that it read every line one by one. And so we can. We don't really want this this new line character. So, if you want to get rid of it, the return value of getline is the number of bytes that are read, or -1 if there was an error or it's the end. So, let's store that as well. Read size. Let's store the read size in a variable. Oops. Let's store the read size in a variable, and then say that read size the last character, which will be a new line in our case. Let's replace it with a null character so that we don't have the new line. And so yeah, here you can see that every single line is without the newline character. You have to note that if in your file, the last line is a line, but it doesn't have a newline character at the end, the new character, the newline character won't be in your line. So that's why it includes it, because sometimes there is just no newline between lines for the last line. So it wants to be like exact. But in most cases, you don't care, and you just have some kind of condition like this. And so yeah, we can see this work. This works, but I would like to show that the line buffer is actually getting allocated for us, and that it's growing according to the line. So let's also print malloc size is equal to this. And here we're gonna use a function that is probably not portable, but that tells the size of the buffer that is allocated. And here we just give it line, and let's run this again. And you can see that it starts for the first line, it allocated 120 bytes. And of course it allocates more, so that it doesn't, like if it allocated the exact amount, it would have to reallocate too much. So it plans for the future and allocates a bit too much every time. And so you can see for the first few lines that are relatively small, it will keep this 120 size. But then there's a bigger line, and here you can see that for this one, it allocated 248 bytes. So it reallocated for you the line buffer. And again, for the last line, which is even bigger, it reallocated to 488 bytes. And yeah, that's pretty nice. You can also, if you know that your file has only long lines and you don't want the getline to realloc a bunch of time and you want to optimize it a bit, you can pre-allocate the thing as well. So let's say I would have a file with big lines, and I know that this was like the maximum line size and I don't want getline to reallocate. I can already just do a malloc like so. More like this, that should be a bit clearer. And of course, assert that line is different than null. And then this would work as well. But it still reallocated the stuff. There was a small error where I forgot to update the line buffer length. Of course, I put it to zero, so it thought that save the file. It thought that the length was zero, so it reallocated the stuff to what we had before. But if I put the actual size of the buffer we have, it will then work, and it reallocates, but only a tiny bit, probably for some alignment purposes. And then you see that it keeps the same buffer for every single line, which is quite optimized. And that's it. I hope you will process files and standard input more easily this way, since reading line by line is a very common pattern in a lot of programs. And see you in the next one.